Hey, this is Dr. Banzai. Today we're talking about data storage and backup. My opinion, it's very important. For most people, that means hard drives, and a lot of them. Here's some of my drive collection. The two older 10 terabyte drives. This one, 5 terabyte, 3, 4s. I stopped buying these because you can't chuck these. They are missing some parts inside. Running out of storage, and to do something about it, I don't have any sponsors, I don't have anyone helping me out with this. I decided to go with a rather simple route, but trying to improve things at least for a while. Still pretty expensive, hard drives are not cheap when you want those larger capacities. What I decided to go with are an additional two 10 terabyte drives, but I'm going to use the four of them shucked, if you've ever heard of that term. Basically, external hard drives come in a plastic case and it has like a little circuit board and the USB connects to it, the power connects to it. You can generally take that hard drive out and use it in something else. Now, it's not always the case. There are quirks involved, but in general, you should be able to do that. I'm going to use those four hard drives together in a DAS, which is a direct access storage device. It has four slots inside. Put those hard drives in. And the specific one that I got, it's a QNAP TR-004 DAS. It can do RAID, which means taking the hard drives and combining them in certain ways. It has various types of RAID. Here's the QNAP TR-004. Four drive bays. Pretty easy to use, from what I can tell. Put the drives in here. And there are some screws that came with it. Came with a nice large power brick. Would have been nice if this was internal, but if it ever breaks, I can probably find replacement for this. Going to use RAID 10, which is a mixture of 1 and 0. With RAID 0, you are striping. You're basically going to put information on one drive and then another drive. If you lose one of those drives in RAID 0, you lose your data. Don't want to use that. It's quicker, but that's the only benefit. RAID 1 is mirroring. Basically takes the information, puts the same on each drive. So with RAID 10, which is 1 plus 0, you're doing the mixture of those two types. You get the speed and you get the added backup capability. That's pretty good, and then I'll basically double my capacity. And speed is always important. In addition to that, I'm going to get a 16 terabyte single drive. I have the 16 terabyte drive now, and I've been copying over all of my data from the original 10 terabyte drive. This will be my secondary backup once I get the array set up. Those are pretty expensive and the cost per gigabyte is not great, but I wanted to take the or get the largest capacity possible currently out so that in the future, if I do decide or when I have to upgrade again, I might go with the 16 terabytes because they might get cheaper by then and then it'll just make sense and I'll have a single one ready. Here is the QNAP TR-004. See the four drive bays in the front. Got a few buttons there and then USB connection on the back, some dip switches on the back also for adjusting RAID, but there is a special setting to adjust the RAID through the software, which is what I'm going to do. It should be pretty reliable and I won't have to mess around with it. The QNAP TR-004 is lower cost than a standard NAS device, which is the network access storage devices. I don't need that capability of accessing it through a network, so it wasn't a big deal to get one of those instead. You're probably wondering why I would go with an external hard drive and then take them out instead of just buying bare hard drives. Well, the main thing is that the cost is a lot more with the bare hard drives. I don't really understand the main reasoning, but it's probably that it's more costly to warranty those than these external drives. With the new externals, I'm going to test them out thoroughly before I use them, because at least in my opinion, I don't want to even warranty drives once I put my actual data on them. To test the new 10 terabyte drives, I wanted to use the Badblocks program, and it only works in Linux, or Linux, whatever you want to call it. So I set up a Ubuntu USB drive. It boots from that drive. It's pretty simple. There's a page that tells you all the information that you need. In my case, I'm using Windows on my main computer, and I use the Rufus bootable USB drive program that you can download on the Ubuntu webpage. Of course, you have to download an image of Ubuntu itself, around 2.5 gigabytes currently for that. And the Rufus program will take that image and push it into the USB drive, make it bootable. I decided to use my laptop so I could have it running continuously until it's finished. The Badblocks program takes a long amount of time, depends on a lot of factors like which type of USB port you use. In my case, I got the laptop ready, I have the USB drive in there, and it pops up to a Ubuntu screen where it says, do you want to try out Ubuntu or do you want to install it? Now, we don't want to install it, there's no point, we're just going to try it out. Pops up with an actual instance of the Ubuntu operating system. Can go in there and do all of the stuff that we need. Here we've got the laptop going with the Ubuntu drive right there. You can see the drive information and the two different 10 terabyte drives, two different terminals. So one on the top, the starter first, the second one. See that is going. Some information there. Now, I don't know if the 25% is for one pass or all four. I have it set up to do four passes. Here's the commands. Badblocks WVSB4096 and then SDC1, SDE1 for the two different drives. If there is one that does go bad, I'll know and I can just have that sent back without any of my personal data on there. Once the drives are verified to function properly, you have to shuck them, which basically means opening the plastic casing, get the drives out, then you can put them into the DAS or NAS device that you have. Of course, this is just one way to go about it. You could easily buy a computer or buy parts, build a computer, put hard drives in it. Depending on the case, you can have a bunch of removable hard drives in there. Now that would really bump up the cost, but you could put free NAS, you could put Unraid, basically operating systems designed to deal with this type of device. I didn't want to go that route because I just wanted something relatively simple to get more data available to me as quick as possible. And I don't want a large, big computer just sitting there. I don't have a ton of room. Personally, I wanted this smaller thing to at least get me going for another year or something. I don't know. But here's the QNAP management software. See, it's in RAID 10. No issues. Go into disk information, which is really nice. You can see the capacities, you can see the smart status. You can go into each one and look at a bunch of information to see how they are. Temperature, if they have faults or anything like that, that's really nice. I am copying from the Seagate 16 terabyte drive. You can see it's going pretty quick. About 200 megabytes a second read on that, which is nice for a single drive. Pushing to the 4 drive array. I did make a secondary backup with the 3-4 terabyte smaller drives just in case. It's always good to have backups of backups when it's important data. I have this other drive in the computer. It's actually two drives. It's striped in a RAID 0 configuration. SSDs, they're around 480 gigabytes each. So I should definitely be able to max out that external drive, but we'll see. Just copy over a few files. It was quite the adventure. It took many days testing things out, of course waiting for things to come in and just trying to get everything functioning well enough that I can set it and forget it for the most part. This QNAP device so far is working pretty well. You can see that it seems to be limited by the drives or something to around 200 megabytes a second in RAID 10. Definitely in the future I'm gonna have to bulk up the storage even more. Maybe I'll build a computer and then just have a huge array. Hopefully this channel will grow enough to support that type of thing. Anyways, of course I'll have links in the description. You can check out the stuff that I bought and am using. And hope you enjoyed the video and found it useful. Scott Gruffy Banzai, thanks.